Imagine yourself in a very dark room, a pitch black room, so dark that you can't see your hand in front of your face. All at once a bright light appears. What happens? Now imagine yourself in a very well lit room. You have in your hand a box. Inside that box is the blackest darkness. You open that box. What happens? Genesis 1:3-5. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night, and there was evening, and there was morning, one day. John 1:5 says, "The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it." Our God, the God who created us, the God whom we serve, he is light, and in him there is no darkness at all. Satan and his minions are darkness and evil. And though the darkness may be great on this earth right now, though the darkness may be even darker in the days ahead, there is still no comparison to the darkness and the light. And when we are in Christ, Christ is in us. So what does that mean? John 8:12 says, "Then Jesus spoke to them, saying, 'I am the light of the world. He who follows me will not walk in the darkness, but will have the light of life.'" So if Christ is in us, what does that make us? Matthew 5:14 says, "You are the light of the world." We are told in 2 Corinthians 4:6, "For God, who said, 'Light shall shine out of darkness,' is the one who has shown in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Christ." Matthew 5:16 tells us what we are to do with what we have been given. "Let your light shine before men in such a way that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven." What else does he tell us? In Acts 14:47, "For so the Lord has commanded us, 'I have placed you as a light for the Gentiles, that you may bring salvation to the end of the earth.'" We see with our own eyes just how much more powerful the light is than the darkness. The darkness flees from the light, not some of the time, all of the time. There is no comparison in the power of the light as compared to the power of the darkness. We wouldn't know darkness without light, and we wouldn't know light without darkness. They both exist, and we should know about them both. But as children of the light, what should our emphasis be on? Should it be on the fearful things that the darkness is doing, or the mighty things that our Lord is doing? His promises, what we have to look forward to, and how we might overcome that darkness. Let us each one meditate on this. Take it to the Lord. Evaluate ourselves. Repent where needed. Make adjustments where needed. And lead as many to the light as will come, bringing glory and honor to our Father. I love all of you, brothers and sisters.